If you've never seen the swashbuckling tales of Pirates of the Caribbean, I would highly suggest changing that. A series known for its adventurous and unique storyline, Pirates of the Caribbean are some of the only successful pirate films in the entire cinema franchise. Hi, I'm Liza, and today I'll be reviewing Pirates of the Caribbean: At World's End. At World's End is the third film in the Pirates series and also happens to be my favorite. With stars such as Johnny Depp, Orlando Bloom, and Keira Knightley, it's hard to ignore the talent within these films. Pirates 3 opens with a devastating scene showing the King's orders to suspend his subjects' basic rights until every pirate is dead. In retaliation, and because pirates are very proud people, they begin singing the song Hoist the Colors, which acts as a catalyst to the rest of the storyline.
They've started to sing.
So much happens in this film, but in the simplest of terms, Pirates 3 is a huge battle between the three strongholds for control of the sea, with the three strongholds being the Pirate Lords, Lord Beckett and the East India Trading Company, and Davy Jones. The storyline follows the alliances and betrayals between all the characters as they try to achieve their own personal goals. All the characters' goals are intertwined by the need for the heart of Davy Jones, which is the key to controlling the sea. Now, some of the characters' goals don't involve taking control of the sea, such as Jack, who wants to live forever, and Will, who wants to free his father, but they still need the heart in order to do these things, so tough luck for them, since this has proven to be a task that has spanned over two whole movies. In the first two pirate films, we can see some very impressive visuals by director Gore Verbinski, and this film is no different. Verbinski has a talent of making the audience feel as if you're actually in the film with the characters, with his impressive set designs, CGI, cinematography, makeup, and costumes. The makeup and costumes are exceptionally realistic and make the characters very believable in addition to their superb acting. You can tell the actors are very in tune with their characters because a surprising amount of the lines in these films are improvised, such as the famous scene in the second film about Jack and his jar of dirt.
I got a jar of dirt, I got a jar of dirt, and guess what's inside it?
Moving on, the cinematography in this film allows for some stunning visuals out at sea and allows the storyline to move along quite nicely. In addition, the editing used to tone down the color and give the film a darker look with cool blue tones helps to aid the mysterious thrill-seeking pirate feel. One thing in particular that has always impressed me with these films is the CGI quality, however it seems to be a tad inconsistent in this film. There are some stunning scenes such as when the Black Pearl is flipped upside down, and I would not be surprised if the tentacle covered Davy Jones walked right out of my television screen, but in other scenes it looks quite childish. One scene in particular in this film that always impresses me is towards the end of the film when Lord Beckett and the East India Trading Company finally meet their demise. During this scene, we see Lord Beckett in shock at the turn of events, unable to give his crew orders and delivering his famous last line.
It's just good business.
He then elegantly walks down the steps of his ship while everything around him is being absolutely obliterated by cannonballs. The juxtaposition of his calm demeanor and the destruction around him makes the scene very moving, and the CGI really just tops it off. The ship being destroyed looks very realistic, and the details such as the splinters bouncing off of Beckett make it even more believable. But then there are other CGI effects that I honestly don't know how they made it into the final cut. And coincidentally, if you keep watching the video that I just played, you'll see what I'm talking about. There's something about these flames that are just not sitting right with me, and I think it's because it looks as if I inserted an explosion from Video Star. Maybe it's just me, and maybe I'm being a little harsh. But I just think it looks really cheesy, and considering how well the CGI is in the rest of the film, I was a little surprised by this scene. But nonetheless, the series continues for two more films, which I would argue are not as good as the first three films, probably due to the change of directors. But overall, Pirates 3 was a success. We get to see the hopes and dreams of each of the characters, which allows some personal connections to be made by the audience, and we can even feel some sympathy for the merciless Davy Jones as we learn a little bit about his backstory. Captain Jack's comical wit is always great entertainment if you're looking for a laugh, and as usual, we're left wondering what might happen next to our favorite sea-loving characters. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed.
I have no say in it, Gibbs. It's a pirate's life for me. Savvy?